Hey, this is Brian again, and today I'm going to be showing you how to actually place some trades in the cryptocurrency markets using MetaTrader 4. Now, if you don't yet have your MetaTrader 4 account and Bitcoin exchange account set up, you want to go back to my previous videos, which I'll link to here, and get all that set up. So once everything is set up and you're ready to go, what can you actually do? Now, obviously, there's two options you can do in currency markets. You can place a long trade, which means you're buying shares, or you can short a chart, which means you're selling. So either way, you go up to New Order here, and it'll show you here the symbols of the chart you currently have selected. So if you're looking at Ethereum to Litecoin, that'll show up, or Bitcoin to US dollar, that'll show up here. And then you can change it from here if you want, but probably best practice to just, place a trade on whatever chart you're looking at so you don't make some stupid mistakes. Over here, it'll show you the latest in the past few minutes of what's going on with that currency pair. Now, the volume is basically how much of this you want to buy, and the volume you're allowed to trade is based on the amount of money you have on your account. So in your demo account, you're going to have a whole bunch of money. You can probably place as high of volume as you want, but with your real account, maybe you don't have that much money in there. And you'll just have to play around with that and figure out what volume you want to trade. Now, you don't want to trade, probably it's not best practice. We'll get into more of the strategy of this in future videos, but as a rule of thumb, the amount of volume you trade should be much, much less than what it allows you to trade. Otherwise, you could very easily get stopped out if your position goes negative. And again, go over all the strategy of that in some future videos. So your stop loss here, you should set that initially on the trade. What that does is we'll see it draws a line here. So if, say, you're buying by the market. So if you enter a position where you're buying, you're expecting the trend, the line to go up and up and up. However, if it goes down, you're going to be in the negative. Without a stop loss, it could just keep going down forever. If you're not keeping an eye on it, then you could lose a whole bunch of money. So your stop loss tells the system that, hey, if it goes this far in the red, then I want to just get out of this position automatically. It'll take care of all that for you. The take profit is where you say, hey, once I make this amount of money, I want to get out. Just the logic behind that is in case it then takes a downturn and you're not paying attention and you lose all your profits, this will get you out of that position. So I'll go ahead and set these. This is some arbitrary thing on my demo account here, so it doesn't matter a whole lot. I'll just take a really small position. And I won't set a take profit right now, but I'll show you how to do that. So you'll see this is where the green line is where I got into the position. The red line is my stop loss, and now that it's on there, I kind of just put a random number there a lot of the times because once it's on there, you can just drag it to wherever you want. And then you'll want to click on the trade tab here, and this will allow you to keep an eye on the current positions you're in. So, even if I'm not on the Bitcoin US dollar chart, I can still down here see where that position is at. So in the next few videos, I'll go over some more details about what all these specific terms mean and then eventually get into some strategy. But for the time being, that's the simple explanation for how to make some actual trades on the markets.